Dear friends, the Honorable Supreme Court of India directed the Bar Council of India, in turn the Bar Councils of all the states, to verify the documents of the advocates, to flush out the fake advocates. So let us take the example of Tamil Nadu or Madras High Court. So Bar Council of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry, they say, their records say that there are about 90,000 advocates on record in Bar Council of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. So due to the instructions from the Supreme Court, Bar Council wanted to verify the documents. Among them, 56,000 people, they have submitted by their documents and they were proved to be correct, they were genuine. Of course, 4,000 people, they could not, of course, some people could not give the certificates, and en masse 4,000 people have been suspended, and Supreme Court once again gave them another chance. Anyway, it is learned that 4,000 people, they have not completed the so-called R India bar examination. You may be knowing, when once you complete your law degree, normally you will get enrollment with the state bar council, and you will be given a temporary sanad, and you will be given a leverage to clear the so-called All India bar examination within 2 years. If you do not do that, then your temporary identity will be taken away. If you pass, the regular identity card, bar council, will be given. But in the interregnum period, people are practicing, even though they are failing, it is not coming to the notice. Like that, 4,000 people are there, right? And ultimately, 2,000 people were 2,000 advocates were identified as fake lawyers, right? Of course, in this 742 lawyers were already debarred as they did not have the proper documents, right? This is the situation here. So now we must be careful about the fake advocates also, right? I know a case where the pleaders clerk in City Civil Court Hyderabad worked as a lawyer for 13 years, and when the dispute came, then only the fact came out and he was debarred. It's a different thing. Now, leaving alone the advocates, now it has been actually virally being published in the Times of India and also the social media about a fake magistrate. Actually, we are shocked whether there will be fake magistrate also, right? Now, I have gone through the paper cutting and came to know this is a case of Mr. K. Natarajan, who served as a magistrate for 21 years, and judicial in the Department of Judiciary, he worked for 25 years and honorably retired, and he is practicing as an advocate also. So due to the verification from the Supreme Court, the records now he came out and he found that his graduation is not, he is not eligible to be enrolled as an advocate. Why? Now let us know. Mr. K. Natarajan, the so-called former magistrate who worked for 21 years in Tamil Nadu state, who hails from Tamil Nadu, he studied BGL, Bachelor of General Law, in Sharada Law College, Bangalore, from 1975 to 1978. So he says for the first 2 years he did not go to the law college, and final year he went to the law college, he obtained the degree. So after obtaining the degree, he appeared for the judicial service examination, and they told him that the law authorities, law college people did not tell him that it is only for academic purpose and not for the practicing as an advocate. That is what his contention. But whatever it is, after completion of degree, he applied for the job. And he got the job, he worked for 25 years, then he retired, now he is a pensioner, and during the year 2003, after retirement, since there is no avocation, he wanted to practice an advocate, therefore he applied, he got himself enrolled as an advocate with ID card number MS1739 by 2003. Now, at the verification point during year 2016, this incident came out and he was asked to give his explanation. He said, what is this nonsense? I worked as a magistrate. Is it arguable? Is it actually... Yes, he studied a point as a magistrate. Yes, he did not agree. Yes, I have already. Whose fault it is? Is it the fault of the Bar Council of Tamil Nadu? Is it the fault of the selection committee? Is it the fault of the Supreme Court to find fault with these fellows? Like that, so many questions have come. These questions, of course, it is difficult to answer them. So now please remember, according to Section 24 of the Advocates Act, who can be permitted to practice an advocate? Number one, he should be a citizen of India. Number two, he should have completed 21 years of age. Number three, he should have obtained a degree from a recognized university. So this is where, please refer to Section 24, Clause 3. It clearly says, after 1975 or so, if any person who studied law in any university in India is eligible to be appointed as a, to be given the certificate of a lawyer. Is it not? So with that only he might have got it. Whatever it is, the selection committee should have been, should have scrutinized his records. There is a procedure, verification of the documents. When once you are getting appointed, there is a process called a verification of documents. In that also they did not find, right? So then he has, now he is serving as a, he is practicing as an advocate in 2003. What is that Bar Council is doing? Do they not know that a person who studied BCL is not competent to practice an advocate? Then how did they allow him? Whose fault it is? And I feel that it is not the fault of Mr. Natarajan. Then ultimately, what is going to happen? This is also an important point. He worked as a magistrate. Now he knows the tricks of the trade. He is now practicing an advocate. What is the harm in not allowing him? So what is the use of debarring him? It is nothing but getting a noose, that's all. No use. But anyway, so the people who are responsible, definitely they should be taken to task, which we are not going to do. Because it happened in the year way back 1975 to 78, nobody will be available. This 2003 affair, that Bar Council president, he might have retired, he might have gone away, or he might, even though he is present, we can't do anything. It is except for news sake, it is not useful. But anyway, please remember, in my opinion, so please do not use these tricks to get a job. Already I have made a video about the pune in a notified bank, Punjab National Bank or something. So when they wanted the people who wanted only intermediate qualification, he has juxtaposed himself as an intermediate candidate even though he was a postgraduate and applied for the job during the verification documents. It has came to light and he was not allowed to take up the job even though he approached the Supreme Court. So, the verification documents should be proper. Had they been proper, this incident would not have happened. Anyway, this is a very solid and sordid and bad state of affairs where it is being exposed that fake lawyer, fake magistrate, all this nuisance. We are feeling bad on seeing this news item. But anyway, we can't help it. But as advocates, please remember, BGL is only for academic purpose, not for practicing purpose. You must be a BL graduate or LLB graduate, that too from a recognized college, from an affiliated college, not for the bogus Magadha University, something like that. Then also your sanad will be taken away. You will be declared as a fake advocate. Good case for interest, that's all. But normally we can't find such instances. But previously, about 2.5 years back, I have made a video, maybe around 2 years back, I think, I made a video where the man worked for a magistrate with his BGL degree. Then he applied for the special JSCM post and then there he was caught. That is another incident. So such incident strangely or occasionally occur. But please remember, according to the professional ethics and according to Section 24 of the Advocates Act, you must have a duly recognized university law certificate for becoming a magistrate or an advocate. Good. Thank you.